Hello my dear students, my name is Khushbu and I welcome you back on my channel. So we have started chapter number 2, the shoeshine boy. So let's quickly recap what we have done in our previous video. As we have started the chapter, we have seen that Ganesh was fed up with his family and the condition of his family. He cannot see his future in that small village. So one fine day, he ran away from his home and he went to the big city, that is Hyderabad. In the beginning, he had very hard time in Hyderabad. No food, no place to live, even no one cared for him. He missed his family. But for the survival, he had to work there only. So he used to clean the cars, floors of the shops, and also sometimes he used to serve at the food shops. Like this, in the same way, 4 years passed. He used to stay at Secunderabad railway station. He made some of the friends there only. Those were some orphan boys and some of the stray dogs. After some time, he started to borrow the shoe kits from his friends when they were on the holiday or they don't want to go for the work, and within few weeks, he was able to buy his own kit. As we already know that he used to stay at the railway station and he was having friends there. So one fine day, his friends suggested him to search in the empty compartments of the train. Maybe he could get some of the bed sheets or some food bag or something like that. So the whole group decided to make a pair or trio. Pair means two children, trio means three children. And they would go on an inspection of an empty train. They don't find anything special. Sometimes they could only get some of the plastic bottles or disposable glasses, but sometimes they can get some of the food. But Ganesh did not like this thing. His mother had taught him to be honest. She used to say, "Only hard work can bring us success. Begging or stealing cannot open any magic doors for us." See, a very good lesson taught by his mother, and he is following it in the difficult times also. But his friends had taught him also that accepting leftovers was not a theft and no sin at all. It would not harm anybody. So his friends used to say that yes, you can take some leftovers. It would not harm anybody because it is a waste only. Remember, I have taught you in that selfless service chapter that your old can be someone's new. So he agreed to do so. He thought, it's okay, I can take those things which is old for someone. Now, it was the turn of Ganesh, Bobby and Chinu to go for an inspection. So, before entering into the train, Ganesh thought that Bobby was having fever, so maybe he would not come. And Chinu was looking for the movie tickets of a box office head. So Ganesh has to enter into the train alone. He was looking for the leftover things from one compartment to another when suddenly he saw a briefcase lying on the upper berth. Now he thought that no one can leave it purposely because it's a briefcase. Maybe someone has forgotten it. If I will take it, it will be a theft. But if I will leave it here, another person will grab it. So he thought that he should go and give it to the police. but he thought that police will think that he has stolen it. So again he was thinking that what to do? How can I give it back? So now he thought that I should give it to the station master, as the station master, the fruit vendors, vegetable vendors and all the people around, they know about Ganesh, that Ganesh is very honest. So they would help him, and they know that Ganesh would not steal these kinds of bag. Now he went to the station master and handed it to him and said that I found it in one of the compartment. See, it took a lot of courage to do so. He knew that his group would be angry on him. They would criticize him, they would laugh at him. Maybe they could boycott him from the group. They may not make him as a part of the group now. He will be left alone again. But he has listened to his inner voice and he had to do what he has believed to be right. And his courage paid off. The man came to lodge a complaint about his bag and he got his bag back. He was very happy and he has rewarded the boy. Railway people also collected some funds for the Ganesh. The press also published news on the shoeshine boy. Many welfare associations came forward to felicitate him on Children's Day. Now, Ganesh stays in a hostel. He is studying in the school and also he will be having a bright future ahead. Maybe after some time he could get a good job and also he can look after his family. So Ganesh chose the way of honesty. He heard his inner voice and did whatever he wanted to do, not what his friends wanted him to do. He remembered the lesson given by his mother. If he had chosen to spend that money on himself and among his friends, so after some time the money will be finished and again they have to do the same work. But now he is studying, his dreams will come true and he will be having a better future. So one must always be honest and listen to your inner voice to do what is right. Thank you for watching the video. Like the video, subscribe the channel. Don't forget to mention your name, class and section in comment box. Have a nice day.